Alright, so I got yet another wonderful backlight kit in the mail today. Normally, I would have put this video off, but I mean, I gotta check it out. It's so cool. So this is how it arrived. My merchandise has been carefully inspected by Alice Huang. It looks like this because I ordered it from Taobao off of an agent. So I ordered this through Superbuy from Taobao. And so how it works is I order it from Superbuy. Superbuy orders it from Taobao. Taobao ships it to Superbuy. Superbuy ships it to me because Taobao normally doesn't ship to me. I know they have an international shipping thing going on now, but that's opt-in. But anyway, here's what we got. We have the Game Boy Light. Note, this is not a Game Boy Light. It is a light for a Game Boy. No damage installation, one touch. All right, touch CLCD. So I'm super stoked for this thing because what this is supposed to be an IPS kit for the Game Boy Advance. And I'm really pleased so far with the packaging. That's a nice touch. Not quite necessary, but you know, nice touch. But anyway, this is the main business here. You get this conversion PCB with these four touch sensors. It is powered by a Pango FPGA. I don't know, I'm guessing this controls the brightness or the inputs. And I have no idea what this is. It's probably a flash chip for the configuration or something. I don't know. Maybe this doesn't have onboard memory. I don't know how it works. Anyway, not that interesting. Here is the LCD itself, which is, I think, interesting. There's no date codes on here that I see, but I was under the impression that these are brand new, newly manufactured hardware specific for this purpose. Look at that, they even include foam in the box. Alright. Looks like you also get these two pieces of laser cut acrylic. I'm guessing these are just spacers. These are different sizes, unfortunately. I don't know why they do that, but there we go. I'm not sure if they're supposed to be different sizes, because one of them's a square, one of them's a rectangle, but three of those four dimensions are the same. Also get, looks like an adhesive gasket for permanently sticking that down. Some more foam, probably as a spacer. Ribbon cable for either a 32-pin install or a 40-pin install. I actually had no idea that's how they were doing it. I like that. And mine in particular came with a screen lens, but not required because this isn't an IPS. Well, it is an IPS kit, but this isn't like the Funnyplaying kit that uses the larger than normal screen lens. Of course, I grabbed this as an example, but it has a stock size lens. It does have a Funnyplaying kit. But anyway, there we go. Let me position that because I'm just totally going to steal that frame for the thumbnail. And let's go ahead and get this stuff set aside and let's go ahead and start installing it. So I'm in a little bit of an awkward position as far as my Game Boy Advance donor consoles go. At this point, I have these two, and it's all shit like this, needs power switch replaced. This one's working, I can use this, but it's not going to give me very good power usage measurements because the power switch on this thing is just seen better days. Also, it's missing start and select buttons. That's an easy fix, but I'm gonna be picky about it. So that thing's junk. This one is even worse off, needs power switch replaced, not working. I know my notes aren't very good, but it's enough that I remember what's specifically wrong with this. If you bypass the power switch internally, it works perfectly fine. The power switch in this unit is just, it's not savable, unfortunately. And even though I do have some replacements, it's for another video. So I'm gonna break into my stock reference consoles and we're gonna use this one. I would rather not, but gotta use what you gotta use. Besides, it's not a permanent modification, so I can always roll it back. Oh, it's good I found that tri-wing, or tri-point, excuse me. So if all goes well, we'll be in and out of here in just a few minutes. I think I am gonna reshell this though. This should be a 32-pin console. I think I used my other reference console a little while back. And what I mean by that is I have entirely too many Game Boy Advance consoles. It's a collection. And I just like having examples, perfectly working examples of a perfectly stock console in case I need to do some tests or whatever or something, I don't know. And that's what this is. That is the wrong screw. I also think I'm gonna reshell this because I'm never gonna have the opportunity again to use this shell I bought a while back. My Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild Game Boy Advance. Shell. Yes, Game Boy Advance shell. Oh wait, actually I'm gonna leave that in for the time being. For a moment, we are going to test it, get some power usage numbers. Because that's always nice to have. Oh, I said perfectly working, and there's a wee bit of corrosion on there. That's no fun. All right. Let's plug that in. Unplug one of those, just in case it starts on. It shouldn't. Okay, it didn't. Set to 2.4. Good. All right, and how do I turn it on? Run. So, yeah, sorry. My new power supply, it's so much better than my old one, except in one way that my old one was better for videos because it had a much bigger display. Well, I guess this display's bigger, but the font on the particular relevant numbers was bigger. If you can even see that, it is pulling. Let me zoom in just so you can see a little bit better. Angle that, is that better? Not at all. Well, at 2.4 volts, it's pulling 74 milliamps. Let me get to the same spot I normally get to, just for consistent references, right in front of Evergrande. 0.85, ooh, bounces up and down a little bit. 0.07 to 0.85. So it's pulling anywhere from 72 to 84 milliamps, 85 milliamps. That's bouncing quite a bit more than I like, but we'll call it 79 just to have something, I guess. Turn autofocus back on. All right. Now, let's try out the new hotness. Get out of here. So this goes into here like this. With the contacts down, I believe. Pretty sure. So I thought that's supposed to fold over back like that. Yeah. And then you can probably tack this down with some double-sided tape. I'm not going to do that, but you probably can. And then the 32-pin connector goes in right there. The 40-pin connector would go in right there, but we're not going to be using it. Oh, that's neat. They have the longer cable and they have the connector offset just enough so that they're the exact same length. See, that's a neat touch. I like that. It's neat. All right. Ooh, shoot. I have it backwards, don't I? Yes, I do. This goes contacts down. I was mistaken on that. Then, that'll get plugged in right there. And, pop the game in. And what did I adjust? I adjusted my current limit. We don't need to worry about that. Here goes nothing. No? Uh-oh. Oh. Dumb motherfucker. scared me. Okay, take two. It's doing something. It has an on-screen display. I think one of the touch sensors is going off. Yeah. Let's see if it remembers what it's set to. It does. That's pretty cool. So, oof, whoops. Yeah, as you can see, it's pulling quite a bit more. 300, 297 I saw was the low, and 345 I saw was the high. Of course, it bounces around way too much for my liking. I think that's the Game Boy. I'm not sure that the power supply is doing that because you could see the ripple. But anyway, I think we'll call it like 330. That's where it seems to be most of the time. I don't understand how this works. Oh, that's, I'm sure that's good. Oh, I just accidentally flipped the Game Boy off, switched it off. Wait for the menu to turn off and then try that again. See, I'm hitting all four of these, but all I seem to ever get is option of changing my screen to black and white and then back to color. Not sure I like that. Alright, well, let's move on then. I know there's brightness control. I saw it pop up in the OSD at some point. I don't know how to get that consistent, though. We're gonna use button controls. Yeah, I think we're gonna use button controls. Alright, so here's the shell I'm gonna be using. I'm sure some of you have seen before. It's wonderful UV printed monstrosity. I'm not using the buttons it came with because they're garbage. I think I will put the stickers on though. It came in this nice box. So good. The foam. Anyway. Use my original buttons. I have gray buttons. How do those look? I don't hate it. I also have these, which I'm not really feeling either. Orange, no. Blue, nah. Gray it is. All right. I have more colors, but these are the only colors I have in Funnyplaying buttons. And the Funnyplaying buttons are good enough that I just don't give a shit about any of the other buttons anymore. And I don't have a power switch. For gray. Nice. Unless this is it. I don't think it is. We need some membranes. AGB membranes. Oh, I'm a little starved for choice here, aren't I? These red ones, but nah. Whereas if I go into my third party drawer, there's plenty to choose from. I think these are actually, oh wait, nope, those are third party. Just kidding. Don't you love these videos where I haven't even decided what I want to do and I'm just figuring it out as I go? I think that'll match enough. Whatever, it doesn't matter. I'm probably just going to take this thing apart after this video anyway. Yeah. I'm happy with that. I have no idea how this works, and I haven't read any of the instructions. Instructions are for nerds. I bet one of these goes up top. Oh shit. That is it. One of these goes up top. Does that fit in there? Is that supposed to fit in there? I'm gonna unplug this before I ruin it. And yes, I know that it came with adhesive and that you would apply the adhesive before sticking the screen down, but I don't know how the screen is supposed to go just yet. It fits so close that it makes me think that the screen is supposed to go in there, but it's not. Alright, before I break something, I think I'm going to go do the smart thing and reference the instructions. Be right back. Alright, screw it. I'm feeling confident enough in myself. We're going to use the adhesive. Oh, I really should check this shell first. Well, screw it. It's too much effort. Alright, so this actually, you do something kind of funky with this. This goes in first. I hate it, but it does. You can, of course, skip this if you really want. Just desolder this thing, or heaven forbid, just rip it off. But, yeah. So I think that's supposed to be centered. Oh, I hate that. Because I don't know where this goes, and once that's stuck down, there's no moving it. Let's do this. I'm going to attach this to this. Not even gonna bother clamping the bail. Actually, yes, I will, because that's gonna fall out otherwise. There, that's in there like that. And okay, good. So now we know that this edge of the PCB lines up with this edge of the screen. Can took the adhesive. I'll just stick it down, and all will be well. Nothing can go wrong. Alright, and the instructions mentioned to do this. I think it's kind of cheesy, but it's probably worth it. Oh no, I don't have one. Okay, I have a fine tip Sharpie. They say to color this in, otherwise you'll see it, and they're probably right. Obviously, a fine tip Sharpie is less than ideal, but we'll make it work. Alright, that should be more than enough. Alright. It's not permanent, but you know, you just gotta stick down all this adhesive. You gotta fold that nice and tight. Try not to rip it. Try not to let screws get stuck to your speaker either. And then, this looks directional. Sorry, I forgot to deal with my AC again. It says directional. Okay, if you flip over the shell, you can see that I have it in the wrong direction. I don't know what's front and back, but I'm just gonna keep rearranging it till it looks right. That still doesn't look right. That looks right. Push that out the front. And now, if you want to be a wise individual, you can leave this paper back on, and you have an adequate gasket for the screen. If you want to just, you know, go hard, then here's your chance. I'm not going to use this lens. I'm going to use a different lens. I am, however, going to stick a lens down temporarily so that I don't keep getting dust or fingerprints on the screen. Just going to peel off some of the hairs here. I'm gonna swap that out later, just not this second. All right. Now, see, apparently it's supposed to come with two different lengths of stick, which is really unfortunate. I did not get two different lengths of stick. I don't know which one's the long one, which one's the short one. Shit, so I'm gonna leave this paper just for now. So one of these sticks goes on top. I don't know which. Can't even put both in without trimming one. Oh, you know, I bet the thick stick goes on the left here, and the thin stick goes on top, because it seems to fit better that way. There we go. And that would go like that. Flip down like that. Ugh, it shifted. Okay, that looks right. Let's I'm gonna tape this down. Just so we can verify. Hopefully that holds it in place. Stick that in there. That. Oh, it doesn't fit because there's tape in the Lynx port slot. Oh well. I'm just gonna shove it. I'm sure it'll be fine. Alright, and let's try it out. Hey! Ooh. Either the screen shifted, or that's not right. I don't think that's right. Touch sensors still suck. Oh! No, they don't. You just gotta be smarter than, touch. Holy shit. So we're not even in a game right now. This thing is pulling over 500 milliamps. That is dangerous. That is straight up dangerous. That's like blow your fuse territory. Whew. Oh shoot, I got distracted. On that. Alright. So we need to test this with a testing cart. I shouldn't plug this in while it's on, but fuck it. Dang it. Need to actually hold the shoulder buttons here. There we go. Oh shoot, I selected the wrong menu. There we go. So now we have that grid and we can see that it is not perfectly centered. It needs to go over this way. So that needs to go. Oh, that's fine. I think. This needs to move up a hair. So maybe I have the sticks backwards. We're going to try one more time before committing. That didn't move, I don't think. No. Okay. So, we already used the thin one on top. If we use the thick one, it's only going to move a little bit more. So, okay. I'm confident in this. I shouldn't be, but I am. I'm going to cut my stick down to this length. So here's what I'm going with. I'm going with the thick stick on the left and the thin stick on top. I certainly hope it's the right combination, but I have no idea. Nice thing about using the adhesive is the sticks don't go anywhere. Peel that off. Usually don't peel those off. Oops. I have commitment issues. Forgive me. But we're committed now. I'm actually gonna get a little bit, just a hair. Well, not a hair, because that's gross. Double-sided tape, you could just use some of this stuff, but like I said, just a little bit. All I want is for this thing to not rattle. I'll stick that right in the middle. Completely optional. And this is why, because if you get the alignment wrong, it's not going to plug in easily. I mean, it's just a little bit, so I can just tilt it, but still. Nice. All right, I'm gonna put this foam right here. I'm guessing that's what that's for, since it's cut to size. Ready for reassembly. Oh wait, I didn't do button controls. I'm not going to bother with button controls. It's just LR select, same as the other kits, really. If you've seen any of my funny playing videos, you've seen me do brightness control wiring. It is identical. Alright, so that, the Game Boy board wants to pop out a little, but that's just the foam. Set this aside, because we need screws. I'm going to use the proper screws. Or close enough, anyway. Always use OEM screws. And the only reason I'm not is because apparently I stole the screws out of that other Game Boy at some point and never put all of them back. I'm really sorry about that background noise. My air conditioning is it's just really loud, and well, I live in the desert, so it gets hot without it, and I'm usually not willing to just turn it off for an hour at a time. Usually I just leave the fan on so you don't hear it kicking on and off, though. weren't a clear shell, I wouldn't bother. Ooh, that is really stuck in place, isn't it? Well, that's a problem. All right, new discovery. We need to lock the bale, huh? And tilt that a little. This time we're going to plug it in before screwing it down. Almost there. Almost there, guys. Ah, oh, fuck. One more try. Do I have one? Probably not. Oh, yes I do. I forgot. Very important part. LED light pipe. At least I didn't get this thing fully assembled before realizing. Ooh, here's an OEM power switch. Let's use that. One more try. At least the screw holes haven't stripped yet. Get in the hole. There we go. Nice, nice, nice. I live in close proximity to a fire station, for those wondering. It's entirely possible it's police, but given the proximity to the fire station, I'm gonna go with the fire truck. Sorry for this wonderful video of the back of my hand. We're almost there though, just bear with me. I thought this was gonna go much quicker, being that it's drop-in, with no modification required. But unfortunately, that does not mean it's quick, especially for your first install. Is my shell already cracked? Nice. Oh, I forgot about two screws. Brand new shell, so I'm basically threading these holes for the first time. That's why these screws look like they are taking so much more effort to go in. Well, because they are. Oh, those buttons are so good. Okay, one more screw. Never drop that thing. That would yeah. Let's screw in a crosshead screw with a tri-wing screw bit. Nice. Oh, I need to do some more power usage tests, don't I? Oh, it's on. Well, spoiler alert, it works. See how bad I fucked up the alignment. Yeah, not great. I'm gonna set this down so it's straight on from the camera. You can see the top right's basically cut off. And then the right, well, okay, basically just the top and the right side are cut off. So, yeah. Is that because I used the wrong sticks? That might be because I used the wrong sticks. Well, your mileage may vary, I guess. That's why I bought two of these things. And it was, these things are like 35 bucks a pop straight from Taobao, before shipping and agent fees, of course. But I gotta put on these finishing touches and then, no, let's do some flicker tests first. I'm sure you guys care more about that. So, usual spiel here, this is the scrolling bars test. When the S in scrolling goes off the left screen, it is issuing a screen reset command, which is going to drop a frame or several. Some kits are way better than others. The OEM screen does show that it drops a frame, because it's light so there's less glare too. But what we're testing for here is to see if there's anything else associated with that screen reset, and I don't see anything. Looks perfectly smooth to me. The other thing we can test with this, oops, with this this demo is if there is a any frame tearing, screen tearing, or frame dropping other than that reset, and I don't see anything either. So the last few kits that I've tested, zero issues. It's been great. This one, also zero issues that I see. But that's just one test. Let's do real quick, let me do the spray. No, not the spray. Gradients. So I can show you the colors, how this thing works. So, oh, I don't think this is going to do us any good because this is in black and white the whole time. Never mind. We'll come back to that. Let's do Link's Awakening now. Zelda.gb. I suppose it's fitting, given the case. Oh god. Did I accidentally put these back into my... I did. These start and select are terrible. What we're gonna see... We're gonna check for any weird glitching, ghosting, anything like that. And I do see some, weird artifact. I think that's literally just... Huh. Well, there you go. There's the colors. I think there's literally just something on the lens that I need to clean. But what we're looking at, I'm watching these posts here to see if there's any artifacts in the grass as the screen scrolls. And it appears that there is, though not quite as bad as the funny playing kits. The other thing I'm checking is this dude's chain. So, again, sorry if you're hearing this for the 8th or 9th time, but... The original Game Boy, actually, I think all the Game Boys really didn't have a cheap way of making sprites transparent. But this was especially true on the black and white Game Boys. So to achieve that transparency effect, what they would do is they would just switch the sprite on and off literally as fast as they can. And with the terrible ghosting of the original screen, it gave you a nice... smooth, transparent effect. With these much higher refresh rate displays, you actually do see the flickering, and unfortunately that's just kind of how it is. There's no real workaround for it because that's how the game was programmed. You're displaying what was actually programmed instead of taking advantage of hardware deficiencies to smooth it out. But on some of the other kits, that flickering will introduce some weird, like, ghosting on the screen. And, like, the artifacts will stay in place, even as the screen is scrolling, and I don't see that here at all. So, looks pretty good to me. I think this kit's a pass. There was one more game that I wanted to test. Not something that I usually test, but something new. So it was a really good test. I don't remember what it is. I'll have to do a follow-up, I guess. But just for good measure. Looks good to me. There is some ghosting, like I said. It's you can see it if you look for it, but it does look pretty darn good. Now, sorry if the color looks frickin' terrible. Trust me when I say it looks much better in person, but this is a very cool screen. Looks really good, though. Alright, so, just for comparison, let's get one of these bad boys. Bad boys, bad boys. Yes. They didn't always seat properly. It's kind of frustrating. Okay, I think they're set to the same brightness. So yeah, just take a look at the difference in colors on the two. They both look fine to me, but when they're side by side, I think the funny playing screen does look better. Let me zoom out enough. Whoops. You can see them both at the same time. I think they're about the same brightness, I don't know. But there you have it. Verdict, is this screen worthwhile? Yeah, I think so. I think it's pretty good. Interestingly, it doesn't get brighter than the Funnyplaying one. And I'll take some measurements and throw them in my spreadsheet down in the description, but it looks really good. It's looks absolutely fantastic. Yeah, sorry. I got nothing much else to say. So the Funnyplaying kit, I think there's still a place for this kit, absolutely, in consoles that you don't mind modifying. But if you do have a console that you don't want to modify, like maybe you have a limited edition Celebi console that you don't want to cut up, I think that's where this kit's going to shine. Obviously, it's too late for this one. It's too late. But I don't know, maybe I'll backlight one of my Eon GBAs with it. I think it'll be pretty good. Of course, the display area is smaller, but it's so close that unless they're side by side, you don't really notice. Yeah, I'm digging it. All I have to do now is just pop this lens off and pop a new one on. You know what? Let's do. We're basically done here. At this point, I'm just going to finish up my power usage measurements that I couldn't get earlier. Hopefully. Need an easier way to do this other than just literally wedging something in there. It works, but you know, it's obviously less than ideal. Bring that in. So this is at 100, well, 99, I guess. It is pulling in-game 690 mil. Oh, that peaked at 700 milliamps. That is nuts. That is insane. Wow. As low as 587. I saw it flash for a second. Oh, it died. It could have just been me adjusting my tweezers by accident. No, I don't think it is. I think it's just pulling way too much power. You know, it could be peaking. I'm sorry, I'm pointing to something you can't see. I have current limiting set up at 746 milliamps. That was definitely me adjusting the tweezers. I'm gonna hit that, I'm gonna set that to 800 milliamps. And look at that, you can see the voltage dropping so low that the power like all but goes out. All right, so in game at maximum brightness, this thing is pulling 650 milliamps. And notice it's not jumping around as much. I think because I have a better grip on it. 600 to 650. We'll average that. I'll set it all the way down. Actually, I'd say I'd probably use it at about 40 brightness. That seems comfortable to me. That's pulling 380 to 420 milliamps. And all the way on low brightness, which does get really dark. Look, my power light's back. 264 to 305. And it does save the brightness level, which is pretty nice. But that is just nuts on power usage, man. Let's see if it gets any better by setting it to 3 volts. Well, I have a green light now. I'm not sure I like it, but this is a really cool implementation of brightness control. It's certainly novel. It's a lot of swiping, but it's pretty cool. Now at max, it's only pulling 400 milliamps. But granted, it's still pulling over 1 watt. But don't forget we're at 3 volts now. All right, I think I've beat this thing to death at this point. Beat this horse. I'm going to go find another lens that I would rather use. And oh, you know, I'm sorry. I just remembered I got something in the mail today. Gotta dig it out of my drawer here. That's not it. It's a nice lens, though. Of course, it's on the bottom. What do you think? Gold? Nah. I don't know. I'm not feeling the gold. Save it for something else. All right. With that, I will bid you guys farewell, and make sure you check out the description. I'll throw links to all this stuff. I'll throw links to my spreadsheet where I do tons of power tests to get a better idea of what these sort of kits will do to your battery life. This kit is going to absolutely massacre your battery life, but there's another reason for funny playing. You'll get like twice as much battery life. But yeah, I'll throw a description to this shell because I know you guys will want one, but it's Taobao, so it's going to be hard to get. If you're not cool with buying off Taobao, you're not going to be able to get this shell. Sorry. But I'll throw a link to it. I'll also throw a link to the screen from the seller that I purchased it from. Again, Taobao. But these have also popped up on AliExpress lately, so I'll throw a link to one of the sellers that looks good on there as well. But I can't vouch for that seller. It's probably fine. It's probably the exact same kit, but it is what it is. I believe Retro Game Repair Shop is going to be stocking these at some point. When they get them, I'll throw a link in my description. But until then, thanks for watching, guys. Have a good night.